Minister.
Madam Speaker, I'm very proud to stand here as the Minister for Veterans Affairs to acknowledge the presence of the gallery, a number of our heroes, our very modern day heroes, heroes that were never given the acknowledgement that they deserved. Madam Speaker, this month we mark 50 years since the Battle of Long Tan, a highly significant and arguably the most iconic battle for Australians during the entire Vietnam War. Today I would like to formally recognise the service of all veterans of the Vietnam War and remember the 521 of our diggers who didn't return. In the early hours of August 17, 1966, the Australian base at Nui Dat was attacked by enemy mortar. There were fears that it could be the prelude to a greater attack. 108 men from Delta Company, led by Major Harry Smith, went on patrol in a dense rubber plantation. They went in search of what they thought was a relatively small Viet Cong group. To their surprise, Madam Speaker, the men of Delta Company were greatly outnumbered that day. They met a force of more than 2,000 enemy soldiers. They fought in conditions of heavy rain and mud. Through their discipline, Madam Speaker, through their training and through their commitment to teamwork, the men of Delta Company prevailed that day. This battle exemplifies the dedication and the spirit of those who I'd like to recognise today, of those who are represented in the gallery. Madam Speaker, Company Sergeant Major John Kirby, a Lewisham boy, known by his mates as Big Jack, was one of the men in the thick of the battle. His courageous actions prevented the enemy from setting up a machine gun post near his company's position. While under continuous fire, he distributed ammunition and helped evacuate the wounded. Sadly, less than a year after the battle, Kirby lost his life in the war during Operation Tambourine, when he was inadvertently hit in the chest by fire from the 161st New Zealand Field Battery. But Kirby was awarded the Distinguished Conduct Medal in 1966 for his leadership during the Battle of Long Tan. And yet, while Kirby was recognised for his efforts, at the time, many of his fellow soldiers from Delta Company, the 6th Royal Australian Regiment, were not. And we're sorry. Because an independent Defence Honours and Awards Tribunal recently reviewed that action of 13 soldiers from 6th Battalion, including those of Kirby. Although Kirby's honour was not upgraded, I'm pleased to say that 10 more soldiers from 6th RAR received military honours for their bravery at the Battle of Long Tan. Among them were New South Wales Welshman Private Ronald Brett, Private Geoffrey Peters, Private William Roach, and Second Lieutenant Gordon Sharp. Madam Speaker, I recognise the work of now Lieutenant Colonel Harry Smith, retired, who was the commanding officer of the 6th Battalion of the Royal Australian Regiment, and he campaigned tirelessly to have the acts of soldiers from Delta Company appropriately recognised. Harry, at 83, still lives in Hobart and is one of our national treasures. As we commend their efforts, we recognise their service. We should reflect on the service of the 59,000 Australian men and women who were deployed to Vietnam and the challenges they faced there and at home. The Vietnam War was a very different war to those that we had previously seen, particularly those that we commemorate in the centenary of Anzac. Australians witnessed the horror of the war through television like never before. As the war drew on in the late 1960s and the early 1970s, it became increasingly controversial to the detriment of those who were serving and who returned. And the protests against conscription gained momentum over the course of the war and men came home embarrassed about their service. For some, coming home was quite difficult. It was a process that has left an impact for decades, not only for the veterans, but also for their families. Some veterans experienced public hostility when they returned home. This was an evil act. Some servicemen and women started to avoid wearing their uniforms in public. This is not in the tradition of Anzac. The sacrifices made in the service of our nation are great. Australia lost 521 lives over and over 3,000 came away from Vietnam with physical wounds. Others suffered psychological wounds that have still not been healed. Making sense of the legacy of the war has not been easy. We must remember the hardship Vietnam veterans faced. We must recognise the service of the men and women who displayed bravery, dedication, talent and courage. This month marks a decade since Prime Minister John Howard apologised for our collective failure as a society to welcome those who served when they returned from Vietnam. Former Prime Minister Howard pledged, some 25 years after the battles concluded, that this nation will, quote, pay proper regard to their bravery and their service and their commitment. They did what their country lawfully asked them to do at the time. They did it with distinction, they did it with honour, and they did it with bravery. Yeah. Madam Speaker, today those words still resonate, and I re-pledge them in this House. As we reflect on the 50 years that have passed since the Battle of Long Tan, I would like to take this opportunity to formally acknowledge the service of the veterans of the Vietnam War, which was overlooked until 1987. I acknowledge the service of not just those who served on the front line, but those who played support roles and those who served for shorter periods. I acknowledge the families of Vietnam veterans. So often, the war has touched the lives of mothers and fathers and partners and children of veterans. Madam Speaker, I recognise the service of our Vietnam veterans as equal to all Australian men and women who have served our nation in their defence forces, lest we forget.